What's everybody and welcome back to another episode of Padge Outdoors. In today's video, we're out here on Lake James. Pretty good conditions out here today other than compared to a few days ago. We came out here and it was literally bluebird skies. A lot of party boats. So there's not as many as today. We're going to run on the other side of the lake. See if we can't catch some fishing. Here we go.
Ready to go fishing on the boat. That was cool.
Was it? Might be one place.
I was trying to reel it up over them limbs and I seen that jig go in the tree. I was like, wait, where's it going? There you
go. All right, guys, so we changed locations real quick. The first spot we did catch one, but it was a little too choppy for us. So we came over here to these where we've done good at before. And we're going to see what we can get into. Hopefully we can catch a few fish right here and get a few topwater strikes. But, yeah.
Just hanging out. No, he's coming up. Should have dadgum retied it.
Should have dadgum retied it.
That's so good.
That's a good
one. What do you
think about my spot? I like this. We'll call this the bass tracker hole.
That's almost a five.
I don't know about all that.
That's a four.
Yeah.
9-11.
We'll call this the bass tracker spot.
That's his name.
This
boy.
Is because this is the first spot my dad ever hit when he bought our old bass tracker. That's pretty cool, huh? First cast up on the new spot. I'll go back this up. That's what I'm talking about, boys. That's what I'm talking about. Look at the gut on that thing. That's a good one, dude.
Up on the brimage.
All right, guys, there's my first fish of the day. It's a good one, too. That chopo can produce some big bites.
You ain't got to tell them everything.
Uh-oh. Oh! He's soaked. All right, guys, so we've made just a little move across the pocket here. On the last spot, we might have figured something out. Caught that 3.5, 3 3/4 pounder. And then we went down the bank some more, and every now and then you see a bait pile, and then some fish would come up schooling. Dad's been wanting to hit that spot for a while now, and that's the first time we have. And we caught a big one, and then saw a lot of brim beds and a lot of action over there. But now this wind's picked up, and the little bit more clouds have moved in. Bite might start getting good right now, so we're gonna see what we can get into.
I better catch a dang good here in a second.
Yeah. Better catch a dang good here in a second. Oh, there you go.
Hey.
Hey, does that 10 seconds before he catches one. That's a rod that he bought 4 days ago.
Which I may have hit it on the boat.
You want a picture?
Well, I had him hooked.
He ate it as soon as it hit the water.
Yeah. I just pulled back on him.
All right, guys, there's another one. I just caught him on Choppa. As soon as I said they might start eating again, he got started bleeding a little bit, but he said
when he used to fish local team tournaments, he'd have one be throwing a buzz bait and the other be throwing a jig or something on the bottom. Watch him come up and get it.
Well, you're giving Willer tips.
There you go, boys.
Watch him come up and get it.
Well, you're giving Willer tips.
How you go, boys? I've noticed some of these largemouth have got a bluegill spot on their gill, man.
Oh, are they mixing with the bluegill?
Probably. Kind of big mouth blues.
Big mouth gills.
A gill bass.
They're so big in here, they probably are. But now that thing's straight.
This is another one in the magic too. Man, we got a fish in it.
Man, it went down. Oh, now it's making a good noise.
Yeah, you gotta keep that tail straight.
Man, like that ruined it.
I told you.
It's actually making noise. Dude, small adjustments just like that can just change everything. Yeah. I better not do that.
Is that the one I just caught?
Probably. It's probably one of them gill bass. That one, that two hook treble still getting them somehow. Three on a swim jig and three on a plopper. There's another one, everybody, a little tiny one. I don't know how he got the Choppa. It's half the size of him. He destroyed it.
All right, well, that's why it's sunset. I'm going to try to pull some wings or something right here. If you're going to throw. Stay on, you big smallie. That's what I'm talking about. Spotted bass. And no smallmouth. Look. I'm talking about 3 inches of water, dude. Wow.
We don't even fish here. It's a tuna
spot. Make sure you
drop a waypoint.
That's good. Dude, he was in no water. God, he's heavy. He's heavy. He's 2 1/4.
Really?
Huh?
Yeah. All right, guys, so we're back at the house now. We ended up having a pretty good day out there. The weather really turned around, and I think it helped it a lot. The other day we were out there, and it was real bluebird skies, real hot, no clouds. A lot of traffic, and the water temp was 85. And then in this video, we were out there, really overcast, little wind, not a lot of traffic. So really good fishing conditions. And the water temp was like 82, so it cooled down 3 degrees in like a day. And so it really helped the fish start to bite, I think. And I ended up catching that one pretty big one, and then my dad proceeded to catch one. And then he caught another one, a smallmouth and a largemouth. So he got both 2 good fish and 2 species. So that was pretty cool. So yeah, pretty fun day out there. Couldn't ask for any better. But if you did enjoy this video, go ahead and leave me a like, subscribe, and comment. Tell me what you want me to do in the future for any videos or something like that. And I'll see you next time on Padre Outdoors.